is going to be the second video of ESO, that is Elder Scrolls Online gameplay. In the last one, I gave everyone kind of an overview of a lot of things, like the stat system. This video, on the other hand, is going to be, well, is going to be dedicated to, his name's Godzilla. This video is going to be dedicated to showing you a little bit about the actual gameplay, and I'll also tell you a little bit about what I think of it and how I like the game so far. This is early access that I'm playing the game in, so that should be, well, I'm hoping that'll be nice for you guys, that you like that. Okay, so right now what I'm doing is, let me see if I can find it. It's not that one. Yes, it is. So, I'm trying to open the door to some Dwemer ruins called Bithysark, and I need to find focusing crystals in order to open the door to the ruins, because I need to use use a Dwemer construction in order to open it up, so that is what I'm doing right at the moment. Looks like there's another quest over here for us to get though, so I'm gonna take that real quick and see what he has to say. Everything in this game is very cinematic, and you'll see what I mean right now. That happens all the time. Just walking through the desert and you lose your sword.
I had an awful battle with some monsters over this way.
Oh. Well, apparently we're getting a bit sidetracked here. I wasn't aware this guy would make me follow him, but orcs can be kind of bossy, so. So we're gonna follow him and see what he's got for us. Feeling this is a massive, massive trick, because this just looks way, way too easy to not be a trick. I was expecting that thing to die in one hit. So, let's go get this and see what happens when I try to take it. Okay, nothing happened. I am very surprised about that. What do you got to say about your sword?
Just seeing my father's old sword fills me with courage. I can do this, I think. I was a hermit. The beast would come out of water without this. At least, that's what Mother said. Now we lure out the monster and kill it. Easy, right? I'm sure this proves my courage to Mother.
Okay. So the beast's name is, Death of Aang, which, doesn't sound all that comforting. Those mud crabs are tough. It's really no wonder that he needed, help in order to go kill this monster.
Let's see if this works. It sure stinks. Is it working? There it is.
I'd say so. So this is how the mechanic works, at least for me. right now as a mage in a game, I only have two abilities that I can use right now. I'll explain that more in just a second after I do this. I'm not sure. I'll hop this guy out. So, I do only have two abilities, but I'm also only level 6 at the moment. I've only really been playing every now and then on nights when I'm just not really doing much and I have some time to kill. So, a couple hours here and a couple hours there, but nothing all that. Consistent. Hopefully the other abilities will come fairly quickly. I don't think they will though. The next one is at, yes, level 20, and I'm currently at level 11 for storm calling. So it should take a little bit, but I also have this upgrade at level 18, so I guess it's not too bad, and some others, but I do have to say that the moves get a bit repetitive. Yeah, so it might be just the way that I'm playing, but so, if you see that I, when I hover over this, the other option turns red, and that means that you're making a decision that you can't go back on. In other words, this will affect the outcome of the quest. So you have to be careful when you have these decisions if you care about lore. In this one, I'm trying to play a good character, quote-unquote good, straight-edge mage, straight-edge damage mage, and I want to do the right thing, and I want to tell him to make weapons, so that's what I'm going to do. It's definitely the first time that I've met a orc that didn't like to fight, though. Now, where am I? I think I might go and find this, find this special brew before I do the focusing crystals. Oh. One of these things right here. I'm still not sure what it does, but oh, it's for enchanting. Okay, so there's an insane fellow over here where we're going who has somehow gotten the idea in his mind. That they're guarding. These were some terrifying wolves. I thought it might be something lootable, but looks like it's not. And anyways, there is a fellow over here where we're heading who has convinced himself that he is a goblin, when in fact he's actually not a goblin, he's just a regular person. And apparently we need searching in a goblin camp for a special brew that he makes. I think that is because he's supposed to come out of hiding. If we set the brew somewhere, maybe, or he might try to defend the brew. We're just gonna have to find out, really. And there it is. That was pretty easy to find, I think. Now I'm gonna talk to a goblin. Let's see. Okay, that's right there. Okay, so on the map, you can actually go to different quests using this, which is pretty cool. It's pretty much similar to the way that Elder Scrolls games usually are. And you can also set waypoints, just like you usually can, which is pretty handy, so that you don't confuse the quest items with other quest items and get sidetracked. Now let's go. So he's clearly a human, but but he thinks he's a goblin, so that's interesting. Oh no, he's human again, apparently. So for my character, this is what the combat is typically like. I am a spellcaster, I'm a mage. And I should have let my magicka regen a little bit before doing that, but my number one ability is a storm summoned from the sky, basically. And if the enemies go below 40% health while they are affected by that, then it explodes on them and does additional damage. My second ability is a armor thing that increases my armor basically by having a lightning form, which is kind of handy at times. And my staff is pretty much a normal destruction staff, and it deals in cold, and that stunts the enemy's movement because of a destruction staff skill that I picked up. That's pretty cool. And we've got to talk to this guy for some reason. Oh, come on. I thought it was lagging.
Where's Mark?
So as you can tell, the quests are actually pretty cool. Thought does go into the quests, like everyone, which I think is very important for any MMO, really. I know that when I played World of Warcraft, which I did play for quite a while, when I was in the military, I had a group of friends who all played World of Warcraft, and during the Wrath of the Lich King saga expansion, we would spend the evenings formatting all the dungeons just for fun, basically. But yeah, that was good times. And where I was going with that is that in that game, I would always just skip right past all of the quest text, and I don't find myself doing that in this game because it's actually interesting enough to listen to. And plus, I mean, you can listen to it, and wow, there's none of that audio really, except for special quests. But also made mages a lot more powerful in the last little patch that they did in this game. Originally, at the release, they absolutely sucked, like really badly. But right now, I actually do like pretty badass damage. I don't know how the damage would stack up to, say, a Nightblade, though, which is basically, rogue of this game. He wasn't even paying attention. This is the demonic summoning pet, the clan fear, that you get after leveling it up once. I think most mages tend to go to that. Why is this guy level 8? That mage was a storm mage, which is the same as me, but he had a skill or an attack that I don't have yet. It's the level 21, I believe. Yeah, I knew that would kill him. So I think I'll go on foot at the time being, because there's going to be a good amount of enemies. I was actually a bit fortunate that that guy came along. I'm not sure how I would have fared against four wolves all at once. Now, are we gonna have to go inside here for the next one? I think we are. As you can see, there are a lot of players already. Even though this is still early release. Oh, okay. I can't go there yet, unfortunately. I still need to collect the other parts. It looks like there's one right over here, so that's pretty nice. One more that we still have to collect. actually have them all now. So we should be able to go inside this dwarven ruin. As long as the NPC is there like he's supposed to be. So this shows what I was talking about when I said it's a pretty cinematic experience. Pretty much all of the quests are like this, so it's pretty cool. It's definitely not boring or grindy, really. Is he already? Sounds good. Let's go. Oh. When you see those red circles, it means that the creature is going to do a special attack. In which case, it's probably a good idea to get out of the way. See the special attack right there, even after it was already dead, which is kind of interesting. But yeah, they can still attack you, even if they are deceased. You'll probably notice that I am using the shield pretty much every time I go into combat. And that's not actually all that necessary. I actually do that just so that I can kind of level up the skill, basically. And I'm pretty sure that I just saved that guy's life by doing that. So he should probably give me some gold now. This guy's gonna do a little dance. Okay, cool. That's one of them. Oh, cool. It spawned a spider. By using the strong attack, I can kind of slow them down a little bit so that they have a harder time near me to hit me, which is pretty nice. Out of charges. Oh. Okay, so it looks like our staff is out of charges. How do we out of charge it? Okay, I don't have any soul gems, so all I did is add a little bit of fire damage, so it's not that big of a loss, really. Thank you. I have noticed that the game seems to be a bit laggy a lot of times. I'm not quite sure if that's been my internet connection just going a little wonky, or if it really has been that laggy, but... Is it healing? Better not be healing. Thank you, buddy. It's a lot of stuff in there. Okay, so... This game should probably be a lot more crowded than it is in this video. After early release is over. Because it releases for PC tomorrow. And then it releases for all the other consoles and things, I think, in late. Like, it's gonna be a while for now, actually. Which is interesting that they did it that way, but. Staffs in this game, by the way, what I have in my hand are like wands in World of Warcraft. They're so threatening. So scary. They come up to you and you have to slightly step back to get out of their way so they don't attack you. Right beside me where I was supposed to go. Okay. Alright, let's go. This video will be a little bit longer because I don't want to stop right in the middle of a quest. Dwarven catch. Found the island. The Rourke really did. I'm not gonna read all that. have something to do with there only being 4 classes to choose from. Honestly. Oh god. I thought I was gonna climb. Alright, I'll just... I'm pretty sure that I could, just run through all this stuff. And I don't think it can be much of a problem. But I think I'm gonna try to play it safe. Oh god. Okay, I really have to play it safe right now. Because I am about to die. But I think I'm safe right on this spot. Yeah, I am. Just barely though, because of this electricity right here. Okay, come on. Go away, Steam. The pipe wants you here. Alright, let's just run through. Yep, that worked. Strangely enough. Okay, we made it. With 2 health to spare. Which is pretty impressive if you ask me. Alright, what's this up here? Another scroll thingy. Yeah. Incredibly complex drawings. They look like a large ship with wings. I don't know what these are for, but I've arranged for your transportation and to secure the team to aid you, including the guide who claimed to know the location of the Zerg. The agreement will ensure your safety and that they will follow your commands. Leave the menial task to them. Do not share information they do not need to possess. Uncover and translate any information that would be of use to us, but your primary task is to retrieve the schematics. Used a spell I taught you to return to Skyrim. That's pretty cool. I don't know what that was about, but it's kind of cool just having them. Just having these little lore things that are scattered around like that. Oh, hello.
There you are. I was just coming to... I hope you found what we were looking for. The schematics are mine at last. Splendid! What would you ask of me? I hear Killeen intends to head towards the island.
Oh, it's a healing staff. Always two options that I've seen so far. faster while I have it on. Now, this would be four dungeons, probably. Maybe not, since you're not really going to be near them, but it could be. And this will probably be for soloing and PvP, because you move faster, and that's always good. Now, how long does this normally last? 6 seconds. This makes it 8 seconds. I'm gonna go ahead and say that 2 more seconds is not worth it, and that Boundless Storm seems to be a lot better. Yeah, that's kind of bullshit that it does that. I'm gonna go ahead and go with Boundless Storm for that, I think. Even though I am a bit tempted to go with this one, just because it probably would be better for dungeons, but just like very minimally better, because I'd be 18 less shock damage. I don't know. That's a hard call. I don't think I'm going to make that decision just yet. I'm just seeing if there's anything else that I can get that would be nice to have with a skill point. But I don't think there's anything else except for... Oh, I can get all overload. Light and heavy attacks are replaced with empowered versions that train ultimate. Toggle to activate. I did not realize that I could get that yet. Ultimate moves are moves that you get from fighting. It's like kind of like a rage bar, similar to a warrior in World of Warcraft. But there's lots of ultimate abilities they can get empowered versions. So since I don't know which one I want to do this yet, I'm going to go ahead and get this instead. Drag and drop the ultimate ability to use during combat. Gain ultimate by engaging in combat. I guess I can't engage the beetle in combat. Let's see real quick if I can just test this out. Hopefully before I make this video so long that no one would ever want to watch it. I didn't realize there was a quest over here. Oh man, I want to. Hold on, no. I'm talking to him right now. There we go. Alright, I'm in combat now. It does not look like I can, That's really strange. Anyways, I'm going to go ahead and end this. this episode here. So, I hope you guys enjoyed getting to see some of the gameplay. And you all, please have a